Hello viewers, myself J. Gerard Lanbrutto, working as an assistant professor, senior grade, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Ramkrishna Institute of Technology, Rajabalayam. So I have planned to take a series of lecture on finite element analysis. For the past 5 years, I have handled this subject for both regulations, 2017 and the 2017 regulation under Anna University. So this ME8692 indicates the 17th regulation, ME6603 indicates 13th regulation. So today's topic is Jacobian matrix. So this is a picture of Jacobian. So this Jacobian matrix subject question is asked in the Anna University examination during December 2017 and May 2018. So this is the overall biography of Jacobian. So he born 10th December 1804, Potsdam, Kingdom of Prussia. He died 18 February 1851 at the age of 46, Berlin, Kingdom of Prussia, nationality German. So the field of work is mathematician. So these are some biographical information about the Jacobian. Come to the definition of Jacobian matrix. A Jacobian matrix is a transformation matrix used to transform from natural coordinates to Cartesian coordinates. So Jacobian matrix is very important matrix to convert the local coordinate system into Cartesian coordinate system. It is a 2 cross 2 matrix. So here you see that dou x by dou theta, dou y by dou theta. Second term, dou x by dou eta, dou y by dou eta. Here we want the parameter in terms of Cartesian coordinate system. So dou u is nothing but displacement. I need displacement in terms of x coordinates, displacement in terms of y coordinates. So these two terms are Cartesian coordinates. But in given question or given problem, in terms of local coordinate system, zeta and eta, displacement in terms of zeta, displacement in terms of eta. If you convert this local coordinate system into global coordinate system, that is Cartesian coordinate system, we need to do the transformation by using Jacobian matrix. This is J inverse. J is the indication of Jacobian. For an isoparametric formulation, we can take the Cartesian coordinate system x is equal to n1 x1 plus n2 x2 plus n3 x3, where x is equal to, we can replace n1 in terms of zeta, n2 in terms of eta, n3 in terms of 1 minus zeta and 1 minus eta into x3. So here you see that as per the derivation of shape function for CST element natural coordinate system, where n1 is equal to zeta, n2 is equal to eta, n3 is equal to 1 minus zeta minus eta. Here, we do the calculation using this. So, I have take the notation pen. Okay, so I just multiply the term x3 with respect to these terms. So, x3 into 1 x3, x3 into minus zeta x3. x3 into minus eta, x3. So now, again we can combine the terms. So how to we can combine the terms? So here, you see this zeta. So zeta, this zeta is the common term. The same way, this eta, this eta is a common term. So we can combine these two terms, this zeta. So x1 minus x3. We combine this eta, so x2 minus x3. The one more parameter is x3. So here, x is equal to zeta into x1 minus x3 plus eta into x2 minus x3. x1 minus x3, x2 minus x3 plus x3. Okay. So I can erase the terms. So here, okay. So where x is equal to zeta into x13. We can write it in a short form: x1 minus x3 in terms of x13, x2 minus x3 in terms of x23, plus x3. So zeta into x13 plus eta into x23 plus x3. Now, we want to find out the term in terms of Cartesian coordinate system. So, we can differentiating with respect to zeta and eta partially. If you differentiate partially this x term in terms of zeta and eta, you will get, if you differentiate this term, so I can write it here. If you differentiate this x with respect to zeta, you will get only x13, other terms are 0. This term become 0, this term become 0. If you differentiate the x, dou x by dou zeta, it is equal to x13, zeta equal to 1. Now, if you differentiate that same x parameter with respect to eta, so if you differentiate this x term with respect to eta, this term become 0, so this term become 1, so you will get x23, this become 0, so dou x by dou eta equal to x23. Okay, so now I can erase it. So this is the final form. Again, similarly, we can write it for y term also. So, the same procedure. So, y is equal to zeta into y1 plus zeta into y2. If you multiply these terms with respect to y3, y1, y3 into 1, y3 into zeta, y3 into eta, you will get y3 minus zeta into y3 minus eta into y3. Okay, so you will combine these terms. So again, once again, I repeat the calculation, combining the terms, so zeta into y1, here zeta into y3, you will get y1 minus y3, because y1 minus y3. Next term, so here I can indicate the different colors, eta y2, here eta into y3, so positive y2, negative y3, so y2 minus y3. Zeta is the, eta is a common term, plus y3, okay. Okay, so now, finally you will get the same y is equal to zeta into y1 minus y3, I can write it as y13, eta into y23, I can write y2 minus y3 in terms of y23 plus y3, okay. So, different, again, differentiating the term y with respect to zeta and eta, if you differentiate this y with respect to zeta, you will get this zeta equal to 1, okay, this become 0, this become 0, okay, so you will get y1, dou y by dou zeta equal to y13, okay, if you here, can erase it. Next term, if you differentiate, that means partially differentiate y with respect to eta, with respect to eta, so dou y by dou eta, so this will become 0, this will become 0, so this term is 1, so dou y by dou eta equal to y23. Okay, so you will get dou y by dou eta equal to y23. Okay. So I can erase it. Okay. Now, the Jacobian matrix, already we know that dou x by dou zeta, dou y by dou zeta, dou x by dou eta, dou y by dou eta. Already, we found that dou x by dou zeta equal to x13. I can indicate in a different color. So, dou x by, this dou x by dou zeta equal to x13, okay, this dou y by dou x by, again dou x by dou zeta equal to x23, okay, so I can erase it, this one, because it will come in the next slide. So, here I can indicate in a different color. This dou y by dou zeta y13, this dou y by dou eta y23, okay. if you write in terms of matrix, so you will get J equal to, you will get J equal to x13, here this is y13, here x23, here it is y23. This is small mistake. This y23. So this is y23 because x13, okay, here x23, y13 is y23. Okay, in next slide, okay, we can erase the terms. Okay. Here you see that x13, y13, x23, then y23. So already we know that dou u by dou x, we know that, so dou u by dou y equal to j inverse of dou u by dou theta, dou u by dou eta. Okay, so if you want to find out the j inverse, so if you want to find out the j inverse, okay, I can write here, j inverse equal to adjoint of j divided by determinant j. So you will get 1 by determinant j. If the matrix is 2 cross 2, we can easily find out the j inverse. Simply you interchange these two terms, okay, you interchange these two terms, okay, this y23 become first element, so y23, okay, this x13 become last element, x13. You can put two negative sign, so minus sign here, minus sign here, or otherwise you can find the adjoint of the j, okay. This is very simple matrix calculation. So there is nothing to worry that. Okay. In next slide. So we know that dou u by dou x, okay, divided by dou u by dou y is equal to j inverse. Already we have find this j inverse term. So we can write j inverse is equal to 1 by determinant j into y23 minus y13 minus x23 x13, element 1, element 2, element 3, element 4. So in 2 cross 2 matrix, we will transform this local coordinate system into global coordinate system. So this is very essential formation of that Jacobian matrix. So we should know this formation, then only we can transform the local coordinate system into Cartesian coordinate system. It is a simple derivations. So today I have concluded that and the end of the session. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. So this is about our college view located in Rajapalayam. So currently admission is going on. You can access this website and also you can call the particular number for regarding admission. And also you will apply through online registration due to that lockdown period. So you can apply through the applications. Thank you.